So we got a new fantasy drama supernatural show showing off a bunch of badass nuns by the title of Warrior Nun. What did I think about the first season? Was I entertained? Do I recommend you all give this a watch over this holiday weekend? We're going to talk about that and much more. A 19-year-old woman who wakes up in a morgue with a new lease on life and a divine artifact embedded in her back. She discovers that she is now part of an ancient order that has tasks with fighting demons on earth, and a powerful forces representing both heaven and hell want to find and control her. Hey, what's going on, everybody, and welcome back to my channel, Movie Files. Elliot here today with a new Netflix TV series review, and today we're talking about the series based off of a comic book, Warrior Nun. I just love that title. I'm gonna let you all know what I thought about this series. And if you've been a part of this community for a while, the way I do my Netflix reviews is the first half is non-spoiler thoughts. Second half is more of a spoiler discussion. I'll leave the time codes, the chapter times in the description so you can kind of know when to pop in and when to pop out. But I'm very excited to break it all down. But before we even do that, as you can see on the screen now, make sure you're following me on all my social media accounts. If you're new to the channel, subscribe, hit that bell so you don't miss any of my new content. Give this video a thumbs up. Helps out the channel tremendously, but I also really appreciate it. And last but not least, if and when you've seen Warrior Nun, let me know what you all thought about this series. Did you enjoy it? Were you entertained? Did you like the supernatural elements? Did you have a favorite character? Let me know some of your criticisms. And if you would like to see a season two based off of that finale, let me know your thoughts in the comments. Let's have some fun conversations in the comments below. So first and foremost, saw this trailer a couple weeks ago. Very interested in this show. It definitely gave me shades of Buffy. You have this teenager who's brought into this kind of underground warrior, badass fighting, characters who are fighting demons. I was just like, oh yeah, this is Buffy all day. I'm a big fan of Buffy, the movie and the TV show. So I was really intrigued by that aspect. And I just love seeing a bunch of nuns kick ass. You know, that's always fun to watch. So going into some of my positives here. First and foremost, there was a certain half of the show that I was pretty entertained by and interested in the lore and the mythology and the characters and their development was really interesting. And one particular half wasn't as good as that one. And we'll talk about that later in my criticisms. But with that positive, half of the show, it was the supporting cast that really carried the show for me. I'm going to get into Ava, our main character, the 19-year-old, who is given these special abilities by this special artifact, this halo in her back. But let's talk about these nuns, this badass group of nuns who is this badass women, just kicking ass, such interesting characters that I wish we would have got more of. But these women that I'm referring to is Sister Mary, aka Shotgun Mary. We have a Sister Lilith, who I thought was great, the best warrior of the show, if you want to call it that. And then you have my favorite character, by far my favorite character, the most complex, the most interesting, the most well-acted actress on the show, in my personal opinion. Not saying the other ones were bad, but I thought she was the best actress, and she was given she just did such a great job, and that is Sister Beatrice. I thought that she was fantastic, but kind of going one by one with those supporting characters without giving too much away in this non-spoiler half. You know, Shotgun Mary, anyone named Shotgun Mary, you know you're going to have some interesting elements about that character. Very complex. Would like to learn more about her, and we'll get to that a little bit later, but I thought that she did a good job. Toya Turner, who played Sister Mary, I thought she was, again, layered, complex. She had a certain swagger to her. She had a screen presence. She had, you know, some really interesting moments throughout the show. The choreographed fights, the shotguns that she carried with her, I thought she was a really fascinating character and really held her weight on the show. Sister Lilith, you know, someone that I initially thought was going to be one-dimensional. You know, she has a particular family history within this kind of organization, these nuns, these badass nun warriors, and she kind of thought that she was owed something. But, you know, again, this is based on the trailer. You know, Ava gets what she thinks that Sister Lilith wants due to her family history, but I thought that she was going to be one note, but she ended up being very complex, very layered, and had some, you know, had some interesting elements about her, especially towards that particular half of the season that really kind of picked up for me. And then again, Sister Beatrice, man, she is like the Jedi Master. She is wise. She is smart. She knows when to lay down the law. She knows when to take action, and when she takes action, it is incredible action. I thought that Sister Beatrice was such the most interesting character to me. We didn't get that much from her backstory, but you can just tell that she's a warrior. She has a history. She has a background. She has this complex, layered elements to her character. And I thought that Sister Beatrice was by far the most interesting character and the best character in the entire show to me. And then, you know, we'll talk about Ava in the positives. I think the actress who played Ava, Alba Batista, I thought that she had good screen presence, I think that she actually did a better job than what she was given on the script. And I think a lot of characters did that in the show. The script wasn't as strong, and we'll talk about that in the criticism, but I thought that she did the best that she can. She's playing this fish out of water. She was dead. Now she's back to life. She has to live with these new abilities. She has to live with the fact that she's, you know, kind of anointed to be this warrior nun. So I like how she played that for the most part. And there, you know, again, I'll get to the criticisms with Ava, but I thought that the actress did the best that she could in the role. I think her, you know, the biggest thing that hurt her was the script. And again, I'll talk about that later. But I thought Ava was fine. As far as other positives, I thought that this, you know, Netflix always gives their creators the opportunity to you know, have the most budget that they feel is, you know, equipped for the show. And I thought that the cinematography, being in Spain and being in the Vatican, that stuff was just beautiful looking and just looked gorgeous from a cinematography standpoint. The fighting, the choreographed fightings, the fight scenes were fine, more so in a particular half than the other. And again, I thought that the lore, the idea of this being based on a comic and just everything that the nuns do, and this, they've been doing this for centuries, keeping the earth safe from things from hell, these demons, just the idea of the warrior nuns was just such a fascinating idea. The execution wasn't all that great, and we'll get to that in a second, but I thought the idea was really cool and the premise. Get into some of my criticisms without spoilers. I talked about Ava, and there's a particular half of the show that I just felt was completely wasted. The character, again, I like the fish out of water element, but it was just, she's 19, she has these new abilities, like, that really change her life, and we'll talk about that in the spoilers, and I thought that they played to that to a certain extent, but just the lack of character development within Ava in regards to where they took the character just felt so underdeveloped to me and just was wasted, if I'm being honest, and I'll get to that in the spoilers. But I really wish that they would have did a better job of maybe focusing on those supporting characters. Again, sister Beatrice, Lilith, and Mary, Shotgun Mary, and then Shannon, the main warrior of the comics. You know, I wish they would have focused more on that, because Ava's character, man, I thought was just so kind of a mixed bag of development, if I'm being honest with you all. Some other criticism, I mentioned the cinematography was great, but the CGI, there's these demons that, you know, I thought that the ghost-like demons look pretty good visually speaking, but then there's like these, I can't even remember the name of, the Talik, I believe the name was the demon. It looked like Megatron, like Transformers, like burnt in lava. Like the visual effects on those creatures were terrible in my opinion. The dialogue, the script is the weakest part of the show, unfortunately. Again, I thought that the actors elevated the script, but what they were given was pretty poorly written, in my opinion. Some of the dialogue, some of the scenes played out was very choppy. I'm mixing that the choreographed fights were believable for the most part, more so in a particular half of the show than the other half. But some of the way that they shot the fighting scenes was kind of lackluster and almost amateur level in regards to how they shot it, how they edited it. The music choices in some of these scenes were just very kind of left field. But, you know, I'm speaking about which half I like more so than the other. The first half of the show was really, really not entertaining, underdeveloped. There's a particular group of people that you think are going to be big into this show that just completely get forgotten about, and I'll talk about that in the spoilers. But this show is a mixed bag of emotions for me in regards to being entertained and being kind of bored, then being interested, then not being interested, the character development there, then not there, certain characters having so many convoluted storylines with the tech company, the church element, the Pope element, the love interest, the demons. It was just like a mixed bag of just way too much stuff being thrown at you, and they just couldn't find a consistent level of entertainment for me. But at the end of the day, wrapping up this non-spoiler half, it's a fun show. Towards the second half, like 6 episodes in of a 10 episode season, 4 out of those, you know, 4 out of the 10 that we got was entertaining, and the other 6 were just kind of lackluster. Give the show a watch, because I would like to see season 2, especially the way that they ended it, and I would love to get more of Sister Beatrice, Shotgun Mary, and Lilith. I would love to get more of their story, and maybe enhance Ava, and maybe not give her so much story. But again, I think the actress did the best she could, but I just was more interested in those supporting characters. So give it a watch. Let me know what you all thought of it once you check it out. But now we're going to dive into the spoiler discussion for those that have seen this first season. Spoilers here, guys, and this is just a discussion. This isn't really an analysis or review. It's just me talking to you all that have seen the show. Let's talk about Ava. So Ava is, you know, she can't walk from the neck down. She can move her arms or whatever. She's a quadriplegic and she can't walk. You know, we find out everything in that first half. You know, she's in the orphanage. She has her friend Diego, who she just, that whole scene when she kills the sister, it was just like, okay, so you killed her and you just murdered someone. You literally, again, I understand what the sister was doing. She was murdering people for God knows how long. And I get that whole revenge story, but just like they left that just completely up in the air. And then Diego's like, I'll take care of it. Get out of here, and just runs in the hallway. Like, is he going to get in trouble? Is he going to be blamed for her death? I thought that the way that they handle Ava's backstory was so lackluster. And then I talked about the first half being kind of pointless. You guys got to agree with me. The whole JC and the squatter storyline was such a waste of time, considering how they handled it and how he just left his group of people. And then they go on this love journey to wherever, you know, he's been all over the world and they go on this journey. And then we see that they just, the way that they ended that relationship. Again, if this does get renewed for a second season, I would imagine JC comes back up. JC, by the way, now I'm thinking about it, and this is a religious show, maybe Jesus Christ, I don't know. It might just be a coincidence, but the whole JC character, I would imagine he'll come back if they do get a second season. But the way that they handled him, seeing that ugly transformer demon and just going, her running away, again, the whole first half of the show, I don't want to, again, I'm saying pointless, but I think that what they did with Ava was pointless. Everything else, kind of the shotgun Mary investigating what happened to Shannon, and you get the tech company, and that tech company, by the way, guys, I thought that storyline was very, very pointless. With the whole, again, it was, I get the emotional aspect that she wants to save her son and came out of left field and wants to bring him to the other side. Like, I'm so confused by the world building of the show, because they have this element of like, the world doesn't know of supernatural demons, the world doesn't know about, you know, all this technology and the science, but then they have these press conferences, they have this footage of these demons and showing these people fighting and disappearing. It's just like, I'm confused about where this world sits with religion, where it sits with science, because again, she's creating this machine to take her son to this other life, this second life, heaven or hell. I was very confused by that whole element in the show and how the artifacts was enhancing her technology. That stuff to me was just kind of, I don't know if it was comic book stuff. Let me know if you read the comics and that's part of the comics, or if it was just a show trying to be creative, which I think that Ava character, I think the show wrote in Ava, because what I was able to find, I haven't read the comic, it seems like Shannon was the main warrior nun and she died in the very first episode. But let me know what you all thought about the whole science, tech, technology, the whole first half of the season, the whole what happened to Shannon with Shotgun Mary investigating that, the JC and his crew. What did you guys think about the first half? I thought it was just really the weakest part of the show, to be honest with you. The first four episodes to me was just very, very poorly written and just uninteresting, to be honest with you. And just, again, the whole introducing the backstory and the origins of Ava and just kind of throwing it out of the window after that fourth episode to me was pointless. Transitioning to episodes 5 through 10. Episode 5 to me was kind of hard to watch because it was, again, the episode where we're seeing Mary and Lilith, which I thought those fighting scenes were fine, and you're seeing them fighting throughout the boat, fighting through on the little boardwalk. They were just fighting the entire episode. And you have this whole, you know, Ava wanting to stay, wanting to go, Mary wanting to stay, wanting to go. It was just like a very hard episode to watch, to be honest with you. But by episode 6, when they go to that little town, that's where things really got more consistent. That's where we get the more of the backstory with the Pope stuff. And I thought that stuff was kind of, you know. And by the way, the father, I saw that coming a mile away. Like, the show really kind of hinted at men being taken over women and being more powerful. So I saw that reveal, him working with the angel of who they thought was an angel and being in that crib, the devil, really. I saw that coming a mile away, so that wasn't really a surprise to me. But one thing I will say about the show that I do commend, Ava wasn't just a powerful being. You know, she had her stumbling moments. Like, there were moments where she kind of knew how to fight, and there was moments where she kind of got scared. The whole fight versus flight thing came up quite a bit, and I like how they didn't make her super powerful. Maybe if they do get a season 2, she'll have those elements. I find it very hard to believe that she's going to be able to fight a devil based on that cliffhanger of an episode, how they left that open. Again, I thought that was a very frustrating ending, because with Netflix shows, we know that Netflix can cut a show on a drop of a hat. So the way that they ended that to me was just kind of poor, because who knows if they'll get a season 2, and if they don't, it's just like, that was kind of pointless. But I highly doubt that Ava can fight a devil, but we'll see if we get a season 2. But as I kind of digress, guys, again, this is just a discussion. Let me know what you all thought about the first half versus the second. Again, I had mentioned the positives to me. The saving grace of the show was Sister Beatrice, who I thought was a fantastic actress. I think her name was Christina Young. I thought that she was so such a great actress. And those emotional moments, the action moments were great. I thought she was the most interesting character. And I would really love if they focus more on her backstory in season two, if they get a season two. Again, Lilith, with her going to hell, like, they should have dove into that, especially for spending all that time with JC. They should have, this show should have been episodes 5 through 10, and they could have just reworked the first half and really diving more into the lore of Lilith and Mary and Shannon. That should have been the first half of the show, and maybe giving us the backstory of Ava kind of in the background and her kind of coming in the forefront in the second half. But the sisters really saved the show. Again, Sister Camilla, I thought, was a much richer character than Ava. I mentioned Lilith, I mentioned Shotgun Mary and Beatrice. They should have just really focused on them. And if they do get a season two, that should be their main focal point. And if Ava's going to be your main character, which obviously she is in the show, give her better scripts, man. Again, again, the actress did a good job for what she was given. All the actors and actresses elevated the script, because the script was the weakest part of the show, in my personal opinion. So that's just my thoughts on the show as I kind of digress and kind of go into a discussion. Again, this is the half of the spoilers, so let me know your thoughts in the comments. Again, if you're going to put spoilers in space all the way down. Let me know if you agree with me on kind of the lacklusterness of this show and kind of the entertainment aspect of the show and what you would like to see in the season two. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Thank you all for watching this review. Tonight I will be having my watch along at 7 p.m. Central Time for Midsummer, so check that out. Hit that bell notification and join us tonight to watch the 1 year anniversary of that. Sunday I have a dark series discussion, so tune in for that. That's Sunday, July 5th at 5 p.m. And then I'm going to be watching this new Grudge origin show and a couple other things this weekend. So thank you for watching this review. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Hope you're staying safe, and we'll see you soon.